eternity of divine spiritual pleasure. God said that nothing in this world come even near that pleasure, but for eternity with no time out. Unbelievable, endless pleasure just for being a righteous Jew and a righteous Gentile. Even the Gentiles have their own test. And there's also a negative side to it. But if you're going to rebel against me and you're going to be ungrateful to me and you can care less of my book of instructions, you will have to deal with the consequences of your actions. What are they? If you're partially righteous, you're going to have to go through hell and get clean, which will be very painful and for a long time. The soul will be cleansed. Then you can go to heaven after that, because after all, you're partially righteous. So we're going to get rid of the negative. Once you purify the soul, like you clean silver, then the soul will go to the place where it deserves to be. But if you're fully wicked, I will pay you the reward for the few good deeds that you did in this life, in this world. Some wealth, some this, some whatever, your trips, your ideas, your illusions. And then when you die, you lost your share to the world to come. You will never get there. And now where are you going to go? The Rambam writes, Lederaon Olam. Go to a place, it's called Deraon Olam, the biggest disaster you can imagine. Why? For not keeping Shabbat. Why? For marry anyone you want against the law of the Torah. Why? For being gay. Why? For being liberal anti-Torah and anti-Judaism. Why? For performing abortions. But I'm a doctor. Who gave you permission to murder babies? Just because you're a doctor, you're allowed to murder? In Israel, they murder more than 2 million babies. More than 2 million babies that should have been now third generation, 50 million Jews, went down the drain because people do not want to deal with the consequences of their action. They go and they act in prostitution and lack of morality. And then when a woman becomes pregnant, the easy way out is to take the innocent baby that have a life and a soul and chop him to pieces and vacuum the pieces. And everything is fine. No, it's not fine. You're still gonna have to pay for that murder sooner or later. He can run away from the court. The liberal laws of New York, the liberal laws of Tel Aviv, but you cannot run away from the judge of universe. That's what a lot of Jews don't understand. It doesn't matter what you say. It doesn't matter how much you identify or unidentified with the laws of God. You will have to deal with the consequences of your choices. So be smart. If you can't beat him, join him. Join him and win the jackpot. Don't be a fool. And one last sentence. If you think it's hard, it's not. Maybe 3 months it will be a little bit hard to change. Why? Because every change in life needs time to adjust. Once you're on a roll, you enjoy every minute. It's great to learn Torah. It's great to help miserable people. It's great to earn your money without stealing all day and worry what's gonna happen. It's great to have a beautiful marriage with wonderful children who comes home and give respect to the parents without crazy ideology that they teach them in public school here. It's great to have normal kids that one day they don't come and say, I wanna become a woman. What are you gonna do now? They all pretend that they're okay with that. Connect them to lie detectors, see how much they suffer. Enough of this nonsense. They pretend that it's all okay. Take a little child and turn him into a girl. Give him hormones that he should have a breast growing. In your own house. Forget about religion. Look what the world has become. Everything that God hates, the liberals love. And that's what I told you before. How can a liberal Jew love Hamas terrorists, mass murderer, and at the same time to love gays? One is the enemy of the other. Make up your mind. The answer is not, there's not, don't look for logic. The decision they make has nothing to do with logic. Once God put a stamp on you as a wicked person, automatically everything that he hates, you have strong desire to like. Even they contradict each other. It's nothing to do with logic. Once you become impure, automatically you're attracted to pork and to shrimps and to Christina and to gays and to all kinds of things that God hates. Once you get a stamp of righteous, everything that God hates, automatically you resent. When you hear that they're murdering babies, it kills you, it burns your heart. When you find out that the majority of the Jews betray God and marry other nations and cut their entire family tree, it bothers you. When you see so many Jews in jail, it bothers you. When you see so many Jews dying from drugs or drug addicts, it kills you. When you see so many Jews don't even know what Shabbat is, it bothers you. Maybe you're not perfect in your own behaving, but at least your ideology is solid. You know to tell the difference between right and wrong, between good and bad. Right now, everyone is confused. No one knows what's right, no one knows what's wrong. Everyone make up his own ideas. And they brainwash all the people in schools, and the children all become like that. Someone told me today that there is a university here in Manhattan, that many Jews go there, that they have a slogan. Be gay by May. You heard about it or no? When you come to that university, they come, say, welcome. Well, they shake your hands, be gay by May. You have until May to be gay, meaning we're gonna make you gay over here, whether you like it or not. And they brag about it. Meaning, I don't know exactly the whole story because I didn't have time to find out what it means really. My assumption is that everyone who goes there straight within a few months become gay. Why? That brainwash obviously affects the subconscious of the people. But they don't think the creator of the world made 2 million species and they all have male and female. They all have to continue the race. That was the plan. You declare a war against the creator of the world and you think you're gonna get away with that? Where is your logic? Forget religion. Forget, let's say there was no Torah, no Judaism. We don't know about religion. We just have to analyze the world. We see someone made the world, yes. That someone is a great superpower, yes. He made in every race, every species, male and female. The male can make the female pregnant and give life to another baby and another baby. That means what's his will? That the world would continue. And more people will come to the world and more animals will be born. Those who died will be replaced with the new babies. That's his plan. Declaring now that all male will be together and all female will be together is actually jeopardizing the existence of the world. You understand that or no? And that's nothing to do with religion. Now when you open the Torah, you find out that it's a death penalty and an eternal cut for the soul of those gays. Ah, but you're primitive to say it. You're radical. You're racist. You're vile. You're dangerous, you're whatever you call it. Who cares what you think? I should care what the professor in Manhattan think? No. Who is he? I should only care what the creator of the world that my life is in his hand think. He likes it or he hates it? If he likes it, I must like it. If he hates it, I must hate it. And it doesn't really matter what millions of idiots out there will bark until tomorrow. You're not one of us, you're not advanced, you're primitive, it's like Iran, you're a pervert, you're this, you're that. Who cares what they say? They're going to save me in my tribe for living a life of Sodom and Gomorrah? What will I say for my protection? My friends influenced me and turned me to be such a person with abomination? That's only going to make my punishment worse. So Rabotai, I gave you a ticket tonight for a wonderful life of eternity. All it needs is a few months of adjustment. How are you going to make the adjustment? Listening to lectures daily. Inspiring lectures will educate you a lot. You will begin to see how your mind is reprogramming from all the garbage they pushed into your head in this liberal country and in other films or in other lectures that you heard in the university. Once you readjust and reprogram your brain, everything will be a piece of cake. You will enjoy the holiday and you will enjoy to see the Seder without stupid TV on and without all the dirt that you watch and without all the curses, and your language will become clean and your future children will be decent. will stand when you walk into the house. They will never make fun at you. They will never give you orders. You, the father, and the children give you orders, and they make fun at you, or they embarrass who the father is. You have to make up your mind. Who do you want to be? You want to be a holy person that lives according to the holiness of the Torah? Or you want to be just another species in nature? But don't ever forget that whatever choice you make will determine how much reward you're going to get, or God forbid, how much punishment. And if you're smart, remember what I told you about the water. You're not going to take even 1% chance to leave this world wicked. Chazal, our sages in the Gemara say, it's better for a person to be a fool on the street, homeless, that all the kids make fun of him. You know, these crazy people who walk with the bags, and something is wrong with their head, and they sleep on a bench, and they take off their clothes in front of everyone. They're not understanding what they do. The kids make fun of them, throw things at their head. Every time they come to the neighborhood, all the kids make fun. It's, Chazal said, better to be someone like this guy, miserable guy, for 70 years, everyone laugh at you. Everywhere you go, you would become the joke of the place. You know what an embarrassment, 7 years to be like this? Better this than 1 hour wicked in front of your Creator. 1 hour ungrateful. He gives you oxygen, you use it against him. He gives you water, you drink and use the energy against him. He gives you food, you eat not kosher and you use it against him. What keeps you going? The food and the drinks. So after you get your energy, you go and steal. Or you break Shabbat. Or you commit sins with your girlfriends in the school, whatever. Everything he told you don't dare to do, you do. But with what power? The power that he gives you. Father gives his son $100 and he buys a knife and stab him. And he gives him another $100 and he buys a rock and throw it in his head. A kid like that is a good person or is a despicable human being? Everyone who goes against God, that's that kid. Take oxygen, use it against him. Take money, use it against him. Take intelligence, use it against him. Health, you're able to function, use it against him. You have a beautiful apartment, use it to commit sins against him. You have a day off from work, instead of coming to the synagogue, listening to the reading of the Torah, a great speech by the rabbi, meet some holy people. What does he do? Go to the beach with a car on Shabbat with his grass. Everything in his life is the opposite of what God told him. Why Hashem does not cut the fun right there and he let him continue? Because he does not interfere with our free will. In the end, et hakol yavi Hashem b'mishpat. Sof davar hakol nishma. In the end, everything will be displayed on a big screen. And every beep that came out of your mouth will be heard in the court of heaven. And every dollar you stole, and every sin you committed in hidden doors, and every other lack of morality that you had in your life, you will have to deal with that in front of the court of heaven. And everything great you did will also be displayed. All the help that you gave to the miserable, and how much efforts you put not to break in a religion, and how much you sacrifice not to marry someone that is forbidden, and how much you're paying and you're struggling to eat kosher food even though it's 30-40% more expensive, and how much you pay double on a mortgage because you wanted to live in Muncie in a religious neighborhood because you wanted your children to get good education and the best yeshivot. Everything is calculated. Be righteous, it will pay off. You don't be... It's your choice. I tried my best. Anyone that wants to get inspired, that's the right book. Preparation for Eternal Life. Thank you very much for organizing it tonight. Thank you very much. Baruch Adonai, Leolam, Amen, Amen.